We're going to go right to another Count Basie tune before we bring out Steve Lippia. This is called Whirly Bird. This is also off of Atomic Basie, Whirly Bird.
Thank you.
That's Will Swindler on tenor. Sean Williams on trumpet. Mike Abbott on guitar. And without further ado, let's bring on Steve Lippia and get back to Vegas. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Lippia.
How little we know, how much to discover. What chemical forces flow from lover to lover. How little we understand what touches off that tingle. That sudden explosion when two tingles intermingle. Who cares to define what chemistry this is? Who cares with your lips on mine how ignorant bliss is? So long as you kiss me and the world around us shatters, how little it matters, how little we know. Touches off that tingle, that sudden explosion when two tingles intermingle. Who cares to define what chemistry this is? Who cares with your lips on mine how ignorant bliss is? So long as you kiss me and the world around us shatters, how little it matters, how little we know, how little we know, how little we know.
Thank you. Okay. This is great because I get like real-time polling right here. So by applause, don't raise your hand, I can't see you in the dark. By applause, how many of you know that song, knew it? A lot of people up there, what is it about them? Are you the smarty pants up there? Is that what that is? Holy cow. I have to tell you, this weather is just beyond like paradise. I was, you know, just home yesterday and it was, I think, it was like 105 on the way to the airport and rising and rising. So, you know, everybody says, yeah, but it's a dry heat. So I kid around. I always tell like newbie tourists who are coming to Vegas, they go, so what should we do? Where should we go? And I say, well, you should be there at least three full days or you can't really get a good taste of Las Vegas. But I'm going to warn you, if you're coming in the summer, make sure you dress, you know, cool clothes, and you bring plenty of water, you wear hats, you have sunscreen, you're gonna be attacked by the sun. And also, there's a microclimate on the Strip. And the Strip of Las Vegas, it's a different temperature entirely. As you're about a half mile away, a mile away, let's say it's a cool, soothing 103. And when you get to the Strip, it's probably 109 or 110 because of all the reflective heat off the buildings, all the pavement, and believe it or not, did you ever stand outside next to an air conditioning unit that is exhausting? Imagine all of that heat that's exhausting in Las Vegas from hundreds of thousands of hotel rooms, casino space, showrooms, lounges, stores, and these big convention centers. So they're literally creating this climate just there. And I've warned people, and I said, the other thing you have to watch about with Las Vegas is you have a tendency, because of the scale of the buildings, to underestimate just how far that building right over there is. How many of you have seen that, right? You go there, and one of you says, hey, let's walk over to the Mirage. It's right over there. 30 minutes later, it's still over there. And it's kind of a sad story on a more serious note, but many a time, you know those worms you see in the summer that after a rainstorm, they try to cross a parking lot and they don't quite make it and they're like two-dimensional? I've seen many a tourist on the sidewalks like that. So they have an entire maintenance crew with these big putty knives and they just scrape up these tourists that just never make it. So please, take a cab, Uber, something. But a cab, keep the cabbies alive. I think we need to keep them alive. So here now is, I think, if after a show when I'm talking with people, and I should remind you, by the way, that some of us are gonna be out at the merchandise table. We'll be glad to shake hands and sign programs and say hello. And if you wanna take a piece of tonight's show with you, you can do that. We have CDs, both of us at the table. We'll be fighting over who gets to sell them first. There'll be a Jell-O wrestling contest, right, Art? So there's some great music available from theirs. Mine, I have, I'm not sure which CD we sent out, but I think it's the...
They both say Steve Lippia.
They do, gosh. They both say Steve Lippia. What a coincidence. Well, one of them actually earned me a nomination for a Grammy Award, so I'm very happy about that. And in those moments when I'm out there and I get all kinds of stories, I used to know Frank Sinatra's dog walker, and I swear to God, I never go someplace where someone doesn't have a personal story about him. And the other thing that they do is, you should have played, and they give me a number of songs. This is one song that not only do I love to perform it, but it's in there just so that we don't get people saying, you should have played this next song. So here it is for you. Fly me to the moon, let me play among the stars. Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand. In other words, baby, kiss me. Fill my heart with song. Let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all I worship and adore. In other words, please be true, don't go. In other words, I love you. All right, come on, take it now. With song, let me sing forevermore. You are all I long for, all that I worship and adore. In other words, please be true. In other words, in other words, I love you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. So when you look at this great body of music that came from, and these great recordings from the collaboration between Count Basie and Frank Sinatra, it's hard to pick, you know, your top three, let's say, your most favorite ones. But this one, to me, really kind of, if it should be in a time capsule, I think it captures what those nights must have been like. One time, by the way, I had bought tickets to see Count Basie, and I'm from Connecticut, and I had gone to this place, a big concert hall, where he was performing, and I was all excited, and they announced right before, they had some opening acts before he came on, that he wasn't feeling well that night. So I never got to see the great man himself. I've seen the band, I have friends who play in the band now, but I never got to see him, and I feel like a piece of history slipped through my fingers. So we're going to kind of fix a little bit of that with this next song right now. Where or When? It seems we stood and talked like this before. We looked at each other in the same way then. Can't remember where or when. The clothes you're wearing are the clothes that you wore. The smile you are smiling, you were smiling then. Can't remember where or when. Some things that happen for the first time seem to be happening again. So it seems that we have met before, and we laughed before, and loved before, but who knows where or when. Come on. Some things that happen for the first time seem to be happening once again. And so it seems that we have met before. How we laughed before, and we loved before. But who knows where, when? Thank you very much. Thank you. We're going to go geographic now with a song about a little village a little further south of here, and a song that really has become kind of an institution. A lot of people have recorded it, but once again, I think Frank Sinatra's version has become the signature one, and we're going to give it a little bit of justice right now if the stars align. Now this can only happen to a guy like me, and only happen in a town like this. So may I say to each of you most gratefully, as I throw each one of you a kiss, mwah, this is my kind of town. Chicago is my kind of town. Chicago is my kind of people too. People who smile at you, and each time I roam, Chicago is, it's calling me home. Chicago is why I just grin like a clown. It's my kind of town.
kind of town Chicago is. My kind of town Chicago is. My kind of razzmatazz, and it has all that jazz. And each time I leave Chicago is, it's grabbing my sleeve. Chicago is the Wrigley Building. Chicago is the Union Stockyard. Chicago is one town that never lets you down. It's my kind of town. Chicago, Chicago, Chicago. It's my kind of town. Chicago.
All right. Thank you. Thank you. Now we're going to do something that really was a big tradition for Mr. Sinatra. He started out, as you know, in the Jersey City area, Hoboken. And do we have somebody here from Hoboken? Really? The whole town is literally 1 mile by 1 mile. And it used to be a desperate little town that he used to, you know, always poke fun at. And then years later, it became this very Tony community because of its access to Manhattan. Anything within a short range of Manhattan is unaffordable now. It's just crazy. And I still go back there occasionally and perform in different places, Jersey, New York. I have performed in Hoboken and also in particular at a couple of Italian festivals. It's still a big part of the tradition that continues from the days when Mr. Sinatra was a wee one. You know, when he was born, he was over 13 pounds. He and his mother both had some kind of major problems during the delivery and almost both died. The doctor barely, he didn't know who to save first. He worked on Dolly, on his mom first, and thought maybe he was gonna lose the baby, and he was still breathing, and he was able to kind of resuscitate him. And that would have changed the entire arc of music history, if you think about it, had he not succeeded. The doctor used some kind of calipers or something, and in his vigor trying to remove the baby and help to birth him, he caused a scar on his face. And Frank Sinatra, when he was around 12 or 13 years, got all dressed up and decided he was going to that damn doctor and was going to beat him up. I don't know, somebody stopped him. But he was a very determined young fellow even back then. And he said at some point, he says, I'm going to be the greatest singer in the world. So obviously not held back by any problems or sense of modesty, he embarked on this amazing career, and he basically achieved it, if you think about it. I mean, he's probably, if not the best, one of the finest of the 20th century. I mean, what an amazing, amazing life. He was an interesting fella. I never met him, but I feel like I know him because the people that got behind my career when I first really got started were the people who used to work with him, his publicist, one of his management team, his music director, Vincent Falcone, and some others. And so they always told these stories about him, including the ones that aren't in the books. And I learned a lot of interesting things about him, but he was just a remarkable, remarkable man. I have nothing but the utmost respect for him. But he would always feature somewhere in his concert what he called a saloon tune. And I don't know this to be absolutely true, but I've always thought it's probably in part because of how he started out. There he was, this young guy with these big dreams, looking across the river and seeing Manhattan, the bright lights, and dreaming someday of being that great singer that he hoped to become. And here he was in little clubs, like most of us. He started out in a rather ignominious, may I use that word, Art, is that okay? Beginning. There'll be a test at the end of the concert. Pay close attention. Little clubs. And sometimes, you know, nobody was really paying attention, and it's late at night, and it's kind of a sad situation, you know. But my guess is that he probably said, you know, damn it, I want these people to hear me. I'm here to sing, and I want to be heard. And I imagine him finding a way to even reach through the din of drinks and talk and laughter and pull people in as he did. Because remember, he could be in a room of 50,000, 100,000 people, and he could get the room to a whisper, and he could just absolutely captivate them when he sang those songs that told stories. And so, in honor of that tradition, I would like to feature one such song. Again, it features on piano the accompaniment of wonderful pianist, Mr. Jeff Jenkins.
Just a minute.
Now, he did a good number of songs in this spot in the show, but this is probably the signature one. See if you agree. Drink up, all you people. Order anything you see. Have fun, you happy people, 'cause the drink and the laughs on me. I try to think that love's not around, still it's uncomfortably near. My poor old heart, it ain't gaining any ground, because my angel eyes ain't here. Angel eyes, the old devil sent, they glow unbearably bright. Need I say that my love's misspent, misspent with angel eyes tonight? So drink up, all you people. Order anything you see. Have fun, you happy people, 'cause the drink and the laughs on me. Pardon me, you see I've got to run, the fact's uncommonly clear. Gotta find who's now that number one, and why my angel eyes ain't here. Excuse me while I disappear. Shawn Williams on trumpet. Shawn Williams. All right, if this doesn't get your blood pumping, nothing will. Then you're hopeless. Get ready for this, folks. You make me feel so young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. Every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna run and play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon, just like a toy balloon. You and I, we're just like a couple of tots running around the meadow, picking up lots of forget-me-nots.
you make me feel so young. You make me feel there are songs to be sung, bells to be rung, and a wonderful fling to be flung. And even when I'm old and gray, I've gotta feel the way I do today. 'Cause you make me feel so young. You make me young. You make me feel like spring has sprung. And every time that I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I'd love to run and play hide and seek. I wanna go and bounce the moon just like a toy balloon. You and I, we're just like a couple of tots running around the meadow, picking up lots of forget-me-nots. You make me young. You make me feel there are songs to be sung, bells to be rung, and a wonderful fling to be flung. And even when I'm old and gray, I'm gonna feel the way I do today. 'Cause you make me feel so, man, how I feel so. You make me feel so young.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Well, so the last song was what I would call the greatest love lost saloon tune, but this is really the number one. You'll know this one. It's 2:45. There's no one in the place except you and me. So set 'em up, Joe. I've got a little story I think you should know. We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. I know the routine, put another quarter in the machine. Feeling so bad, won't you make the music easy and sad? Well, I could tell you a lot, but it's gotta be in a gentleman's code. Make it one for my baby and one more for the road. You'd never know it, but buddy, I'm a kind of poet, and I've got a lot of things I need to say. When I'm gloomy, please listen to me till it's talked away.
that's how it goes. Joe, I know you're getting anxious to close. And thanks for the cheer. I hope you didn't mind my bending your ear. See this torch that I found, it's gotta be bound, or it soon might explode. Make it one for my baby, and one more for the road. The long, it's been so long, so long, so, so long.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Take a bow, Jeff. Jeff Jenkins, beautiful, wonderful. Well, I have to tell you, this has been just a wonderful, wonderful night. I just can't tell you how honored we are that you all stepped away from your 250 channels, your wireless devices, your mobile devices, although I see a few of them blinking here and there, your laptops, iPads and iPhones and iCars and iCouches, and you came out here tonight to listen to live music. Let's hear it for yourselves. And while I love to sing, it just would not be the same without some incredible musicianship to make me sound good. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for the Colorado Jazz Repertory Orchestra. Director Art Bouton. Thank you very much, guys. Do you have a few parting words?
No, we're good.
Okay, so listen, we'll see you out there somewhere where the tables are. Come on up and say hello. And before we leave, we have one more song. It wasn't from 1966, from 1979. And you'll know why when you hear it. Start spreading the news. I fooled you, didn't I? I'm leaving today. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes, they are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York, New York. I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep and find I'm king of the hill, top of that heap. These little town blues, they are melting away. I'll make a brand new start of it in old New York. If I can make it there, I'll make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York, New York. Okay, now, this is the part where you're gonna sing, and I mean loudly. Get ready. New York, I want to wake up in a city that doesn't sleep and find I'm a number one, top of the list, king of the hill, a number one.
part of it. In old New York. And if I can make it there, I'm gonna make it anywhere. It's up to you, New York.
Steve Lippia and the Colorado Jazz Repertory Orchestra. We look forward to seeing you back here October 20th. Ladies and gentlemen, Steve Lippia. Let's bring Steve Lippia back out here for another hand. Steve Lippia and the Colorado Jazz Repertory Orchestra. You've been a great audience. Steve Lippia.